Bonjour, bonsoir, Kevin. So the last time we talked about l'imparfait. L'imparfait is, well, all you have to remember is, you know, the endings. AIS, AIS, AIT, IONS, IEZ, AIENT. So that's a verb to have. We are talking about the past, past progressive, past habits, ongoing action, uninterrupted action in the past. So, and it comes with some expressions. À l'époque du rock, that time, the rock période, j'avais 15 ans. I was 15. Tu avais 20 ans. You were 20. Il avait des disques américains. He had American vinyls, you know, the discs. Nous avions des guitares. We had guitars. Vous aviez une Vespa, you had a Vespa scooter. Elles avaient une deux chevaux. Two seat, deux chevaux, it's like this kind of a own car. Let me see if I can find you something. So, deux chevaux. Yeah, this. Deux chevaux. Okay. C'est like Citroën, two CV. Deux chevaux. Very popular. So, now coming back to this. There we go. The use is past habits. Maintenant, j'habite à Paris, je travaille chez IBM, it's a present tense. Now I live in Paris and I work for IBM. Or I work at IBM. Avant, j'habitais à Marseille, je travaillais chez BMI. Before, so be careful, hein? Another important expression like this one, à l'époque, at the time, before, avant. I lived in Paris, in Marseille, and I was working for BMI. Okay. So after some expressions, we use imparfait. À cette époque-là, that time, avant, before, quand j'étais jeune, when I was young, j'avais les cheveux longs, I had long hair. So it's very important to know the present tense. But we're just talking about regular verbs here, so it's not a big deal. But I would say, you know, parler, we just drop the ER and we add the following endings here. Okay? I tend to simplify to ex the extreme to help my students to remember better. So, nous parlons, je parlais, that's imparfait. Prendre, so I'm going to drop the DRE. Okay, I'm gonna add the ending. Finir, we're gonna put that on the side because we need to come back to the present here. Okay. Manger, we need to have the j sound, not the g. So je mangeais, okay, et je commençais. Okay. But for the time being, we're gonna just talk about regular verbs. So être, well, we're gonna drop the re and j'étais, tu étais, il était, nous étions, vous étiez, ils étaient. J'avais, tu avais, il avait, nous avions, vous aviez, ils avaient, elles avaient. Okay? So, if I want to go through one exercise, I'm going to be like, okay, maintenant, je marche très peu, mais avant, je marchais beaucoup. Okay? So, that would be like one way of saying it. So, let me just open something here, text edit. Yeah, there we go. And there we go. So, what I want to say is, maintenant je parle beaucoup. Now I talk a lot, I speak a lot. Mais avant, je parlais peu. Okay? Maintenant je mange très peu. Mais avant, je mangeais beaucoup. Maintenant je conduis lentement. Mais avant, je conduisais plus vite. I can say comme un fou. Je conduisais comme un fou, like a crazy maniac. Maintenant, je dors mal. Mais avant, je dormais mieux. Better. Before, I was sleeping badly, you know, barely sleeping. But no, now I don't sleep very well, but before I was sleeping better. Okay, better. There we go. Maintenant, je ne fais plus de sport. So now I don't exercise, work out. But before, mais avant, je faisais 4 heures de sport, okay, par jour. Maintenant, je suis très pessimiste, mais avant, j'étais très optimiste. Okay. So, let's not go too far because we still have to talk about the present form. Okay. So, here, we did also the passé composé. Let me just see if I can find the page. So, passé composé avec avoir. Okay, but I want to show you the links because it's quite important. So I'm summarizing here, okay? So imparfait, let's just go through this stuff. You can listen, I don't have to read the whole thing. Okay, so what kind of a child were you? I was very calm and very curious. How were you spending your free time? As a child, I was going out. I was leaving very, very rarely the house. I was playing with my brothers and sisters, and we were spending Wednesdays and Sundays quietly in the family. Sometimes we were going to the movies with the family, but it was very rare. You didn't have any friends? Yes, of course. I had classmates, but they were never coming at home. You were practicing a sport. I was doing some horse riding every Wednesday afternoon. I loved it. Were you playing an instrument? Yes, I was playing violin. Besides, my parents also were playing violin. Where were you spending your vacation? So every year, my parents were bringing us along to Brittany. Well, I don't really like this. Let me just check. Emmener. Emmener les enfants à l'école, to take the children to school. Yeah, that's it. So, we're taking us to Brittany, next to, close to Saint-Malo. My uncle had it's like a secondary house, or, you know, over there. I love this place. Endroit is a place. We could go to the sea every day. To the sea. So here the video is going to explain you different things. So I'm not gonna play it because there is now this big copyright infringement on YouTube and they're driving me crazy. So you'll see, okay? The questions, you can see the answers. Quel était le caractère de l'écrivaine? Elle était calme et très curieuse. Comment passait-elle ses dimanches? Elle les passait en famille. Faisait-elle du sport? Oui, elle faisait de l'équitation. Jouait-elle d'un instrument de musique? Oui, elle jouait du violon. Vrai ou faux? L'écrivaine n'avait pas d'amis, c'est faux. Elle allait souvent au cinéma, c'est faux. Elle n'aimait pas le sport, c'est faux. Et elle passait ses vacances dans une région de l'ouest de la France, oui, à côté de Saint-Malo, en Bretagne. Okay. Et ici, on a un autre dialogue donc, qui continue. Donc, could you talk about the house, your uncle's house? Yes, it was. So, elle était, because the house is feminine. It was big. There was like 5 or 6... bedrooms. The dining room was gigantic. We had like incredible meals. My uncle was always inviting tons of friends who were all bringing like something small to eat. And in the end, it was giving like a large meal. We were calling that le compotatio, but I'm not sure that this term exists really. Were there a garden? Paradoxically, the garden was not as big as the house. It was minuscule. almost ridiculous compared to the humongous house. But this didn't have any, was not really important. We were always by the sea because the house was located like two steps away from the beach. Okay. Donc ici, on a l'imparfait. Je reviens. Quelque part, somewhere. Quelqu'un, someone. Quelque chose, something. Okay. Attention au verbe se souvenir. Je me souviens. I remember. Okay. We have the verb être. J'étais, tu étais, il était. Nous étions, vous étiez, ils étaient. Sortir, to go out. Okay. So anyway, I just want to make sure this is also understood. Hein? The same drill. You know, qu'est-ce que tu as fait aujourd'hui? La 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 la. We're gonna go through this stuff hein, together. Because we have to review the passé composé. And this partitives. Le petit déjeuner, le pain. So breakfast, bread, tea, coffee, milk. It's like powdered chocolate, cereals, butter, jam, strawberry jam, marmalade, honey, yogurt, sugar, water. The rice, a bowl of rice, ham, soup, miso soup, vegetables, salad, bacon, egg, omelette, biscotti, noodles, croissant, and brioche. Okay. And the quantity du pain, so some bread, some sugar, with sugar, without sugar, sugar-free, a glass of water, a glass of a cup of tea, and yogurts. Prendre. So take. Hein. Je prends, tu prends, il prend, nous prenons, vous prenez, ils prennent. Yeah, I'm gonna go through this stuff again. So, hello, have you slept well? Yes, I slept well, thank you. What do you take for breakfast? Il y a quoi? It's like, what's there? I mean, what do you have? It's not a literal transition. So, tea, coffee, there's also milk, powdered chocolate, cereals, bread, butter, strawberry jam, marmalade, and there is also honey and yogurt. I'm gonna take bread with honey, tea, coffee. I take coffee with sugar, no, without sugar. Here is a cup of tea without sugar. And you only, seulement is only, take water. Yes, only a glass of water. No, I'm kidding, I already ate. Je plaisante. Okay, so anyway. Just be careful, hein, because we're talking about the quantity. So, le passé composé avec avoir, that is something we're going to study. Okay. Just make sure you are practicing. And the indicator of time, we're going to see that it's super important. Okay. Anyways, it's going to be a good exercise. You have a nice week, and I'll talk to you on Wednesday evening. Au revoir, Kevin. À très, très bientôt.